This homework concerns anagrams. Now, an anagram is a rearrangement of letters in a word or phrase to form new words or phrases. So, for example, an anagram of the phrase anagrams could be, we start pulling out letters and we could say an, and then maybe arm, and then we're left with G-A-S, we could write that S-A-G. So this phrase is an anagram of that one because it uses all and no more of the letters. It's okay to have extra spaces in between the words here. There could have been extra spaces between the words here. It could have been a multi-word phrase. Spaces don't matter, just that you use up all the letters. And so your task is going to be to write the function anagrams, which takes as input a phrase, which is a string, like the string anagrams, or it could be a string with multiple words separated by spaces, and then an optional argument saying, what's the shortest word you're going to accept in the answer? So here, we allow two-letter words and up. If we wanted, we could say we'll only allow three-letter words and up, or so on. And this is going to return a set of phrases, which may be multi-word phrases, like that. Now, we'll be generating all possibilities from the words in the dictionary. So these words are all in the dictionary. But notice that for these three words, they could appear in any of six possible orders, three factorial possible orders. And it would be kind of boring and repetitious to see all of those. So we're only going to show out of each of those six possibilities or n factorial possibilities for an n-word phrase, only show the one that's in alphabetical order. So here, the word an is alphabetically before the word arm, which is alphabetically before the word sag. So that's the representative we've shown out of the six possibilities. So I want you to generate that set, and you can use things that we've had before, like the set of words and prefixes that we've already defined, and you might find it useful to reuse functions such as find words. Here's the skeleton of the function with its signature. It's going to return a set of words, and here's some examples of calling anagrams, checking to see some of the results are a member of those set, and here we've listed the complete set against our small dictionary of words for anagrams of the words pythonic. I notice here that we have hypnotic, but not hypnotic, because hypnotic happened not to be in our dictionary, even though hypnotic is an anagram of pythonic. Go ahead and write your code here, and feel free to copy and paste whatever previous code you need.